me in your Bibles to Luke chapter 12. Thank you, Van, for leading us. Kiddos are welcome to head with Miss Rhonda. Luke chapter 12. As you're turning there, we are going to tip over into chapter 13. Go to 13:17. And as we cross over this morning, I want you to notice we're midway through the Gospel of Luke. That's right. I counted how far out. So the plan is this, is to go to Easter. And Lord willing, we can do that. But I want you to think, we're midway through. There are themes this morning you will hear of the kingdom of God. Jesus is speaking to the religious. He's addressing his disciples, yet he's also addressing the crowd. And one of the main themes we'll see this morning is unbelief. Unbelief. And the urgency to believe. There is still a blindness among God's people. And Jesus stands ready to bring freedom. Would you stand with me in the honor of the reading of the Word of God, if you're able? Again, we're picking up in Luke 12, verse 57, and taking it all the way to 13:17. So read with me. Jesus says, "And why do you not judge for yourself what is right? As you go with your accuser before the magistrate, make an effort to settle with him on the way, lest he drag you to the judge, and the judge hand you over to the officer, and the officer put you in prison. I tell you, you will never get out until you have paid the very last penny." Chapter 13. There were some present at this very time who told him about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And he answered them, "Do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they suffered in this way? No. I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all likewise perish." Or those 18 on whom the Tower of Siloam fell and killed them, do you think that they were worse offenders than all the offenders who lived in Jerusalem? No, I tell you, but unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. And he told this parable. A man had a fig tree planted in a vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. And he said to the vine dresser, "Look, for 3 years now I have come seeking fruit from this tree, and I find none. Cut it down. Why should it use up the ground?" And he answered him, "Sir, let it alone for a year also, until I dig around it and put on manure. Then if it should bear fruit next year, well, good. But if not, then you can cut it down." Now, he was teaching in the synagogue on the Sabbath, and behold, there was a woman who had a debilitating spirit for 18 years. She was bent over and could not fully straighten herself. And when Jesus saw her, he called her over and said to her, "Woman, you are freed from your disability." And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight, and she glorified God. But the ruler of the synagogue, indignant because Jesus had healed on the Sabbath, said to the people, "There are 6 days in which work ought not be done. Come on one of those days. I'm sorry, work should be done. Come on one of those days and be healed, and not on the Sabbath day." And then the Lord answered him, "You hypocrites. Does not each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his donkey from the manger and let it away to water it? And ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 years, be loosed from the bond on the Sabbath day? And as he said these things, all his adversaries were put to shame, and all the people rejoiced at all the glorious things that were done by him. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for your son, Jesus, that he taught with authority. He was your son in whom you were pleased. And Luke writes this gospel so that we might know who Jesus is. Still today, I pray that we might know who Jesus is. I know how we need Jesus. We are so religious. We're so caught up in ourselves. We love to point fingers at others. So would you help us? That's what I pray. I pray, Holy Spirit, illuminate your word. And you would help us this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You can be seated. We're covering quite a bit. But I believe that it all fits together. I believe Luke is writing in such a way, and that we can even hold them together this morning and see what Jesus is doing. There is a crowd here with Jesus that cannot see their own sin. And Jesus is calling them to repent. Repent. He first starts in a courtroom situation. You look there in your Bible, verse 57, we just read. And Jesus, what he's saying is, it's better to settle with someone on the way than to get before the judge or be drugged before the judge. It's better to settle with them than to be handed over to the officer. I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.